Hey YouTube, it's Bass. Well, I hope you guys enjoyed my last two videos. I got a lot of great comments on the last video I did on the PSP. That was actually a pretty good video, I think, because it really triggered a lot of people's ASMR, and it really helped you guys get to sleep or get you to relax. I do have a lot of different videos coming up in the timeline here, and I hope you guys continue to watch, and I hope you guys are really relaxed. I do thank a lot of you for subscribing. I actually got like 25 subscribers in the first, 24 hours of my channel, so I really do have you guys to thank for that. I've been getting a lot of great comments from a lot of I call them pro whisperers, and I take all their comments to heart. So I just wanted to again thank you all for supporting me, and thank you guys for watching my videos to come to be relaxed. I hope they helped for you. I guess for this video, I just wanted to talk about a little bit about me, and I know a lot of people do that a lot, so let's just talk about the basics. I was born in Boston, Massachusetts, to a pretty big family, actually. I really didn't realize how big my family was until recently, but yeah. I've lived here pretty much all my life, except for college, where I went to when I went to Arizona to live for about 4 years. That was a pretty big experience, but I'll come to that later. I grew up a big wrestling fan for a lot of my years, and I don't think I'll ever stop being a wrestling fan. It's just one of those things where if you love something so much, you just can't stop doing it. And it's one of those things where you keep getting entertained, even though it's pretty corny, even though it's pretty lame to some other people. But at one time, it was very popular. Back in the day, I was a big Bret the Hitman Hart fan. Then it became Stone Cold and The Rock, and now CM Punk is the latest. But that was a lot of my childhood, and another part of my childhood is, if you can see behind me, are video games, and video games are a huge part of my life. It's what I went to college for. It's what I've done since I was 3 years old, 4 years old. I started on a regular Nintendo. That's when I actually started. I then moved on to the Super Nintendo and the Genesis, and moving up and so on. I didn't start on the Atari like a lot of other people have, but it's been like that dodgy type of thing when it came to video games back then. Back then I used to call tight a lot, and then obviously you could tell I stopped doing that a long time ago. I think I really fell in love with video games around the Nintendo 64 days, when Zelda came out. I think Zelda was the one that like cemented it. It's been my favorite game ever since. My favorite video game console of all time is the Sega Dreamcast. Sega Dreamcast was just an amazing system with a lot of possibility, but unfortunately, things didn't work out. Back in my days when I was going to school, I wasn't actually really liked in my younger years. I was kind of like that outcast guy. I used to get picked on all the time, beat up sometimes, but I never really let it bother me all that much. I just moved on. Typical, pretty typical childhood of an American. chose to go to Aruba. As a kid, you probably want to go to Disneyland, but not me. I wanted to go to Aruba. That was strange like that. What else? Around that time, Western Wrestling was really big, and I was a big Stone Cold fan, and I used to walk and talk like him all the time, and I used to do catchphrases like The Rock and stuff like that. I was an interesting child. At that point, I wasn't really talkative, so it was kind of like a social crush of mine to stand out. So that's what I used to do, and I think some people liked it and other people didn't. And I probably got a lot of shit for it. Social that I now want to be a community manager in the video game industry. That's what I want to do, and that's what I'm really passionate about. I'm also passionate about doing these videos too, but I went to college for multimedia with emphasis on game design. That's how it was supposed to be at first, but then at school small school, and we got national accreditation and regional accreditation, and things started to change, and my degree became a game design major rather than a multimedia. However, with the multimedia background, I was able to do a little bit more things. I attended clubs, I ran events at the school, and I think that's when after I graduate, that's when it hit me that I'd rather be a community manager or something in marketing. So right now, I'm contemplating about going back to school and doing those things. And lately, I've been working for this website that I do, and I think we're about ready to really take off, and I think we're on the cusp of getting something really special. Visit the website someday when it really launches, and you'll see a very cool looking site. I've learned a lot about myself and a lot about other things, and I think that's what makes me a little bit different, and I think it's part of the reason why I'm changing a lot. Like, I have a job that I'm not too happy with, but on the other hand, I have another job that I'm pretty happy with. So, I mean, one is paying, one's not, so I have to figure out what I want to do in life and if I really want to continue, which path I want to continue on. Because right now it's going like this, but I want it to go more like this. Or just more like this. I think one of these days I'll figure out what I want to do, and that will be just as good as trying to figure out what to do. Yeah, and that's pretty much me. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. I tried to give you a little something. I have a lot of other videos planned for the next couple of weeks. I've been pretty busy this week with work and stuff, but that's to be expected. I'll try to do some outside videos as well. stuff like that. But as for now, I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I'll see you some other day. Now go to sleep. Go to sleep.